This is an introduction to combining FPGA HDL code with RF for software-defined radio physical layer waveform design. This video will discuss combining HDL code for an FPGA application with RF for software-defined radio physical layer waveform design and verification. The waveform source for our system design will consist of HDL code that has been generated from a fixed-point IQ modulator. The HDL code is shown down below here, and if I push into the IQ modulator, we can see the fixed point design that was used to generate this HDL. Now this video is actually an extension of several other videos which are available, one of which is software defined radio fixed point IQ modulator design, in which we discuss the design of this IQ modulator. The other is introduction to HDL generation and HDL co-simulation, in which we discuss generating HDL code from this fixed point IQ modulator and then co-simulating with that HDL. Now let's take a closer look at our design and then we'll perform a simulation. So on the far left hand side we have our HDL co-simulation element set up to co-simulate with the HDL that was shown in that directory. Let me just zoom into the transmitter. This is a transmitter which converts the digital IF up to an RF frequency. We have a bandpass filter filtering the IF. We then have a mixer and an LO which is being used to upconvert the signal. We could specify phase noise if we'd like with this LO. We then filter the upconverted signal, pass through a preamplifier, and for this preamplifier we have gain and a 1 dB compression point assigned. We then have a VSA sync element to measure the simulated output of the preamplifier. There's another RF filter, and then we have a power amplifier with a gain and a 1 dB compression point also associated with it. And then we have another VSA sync element on the far right hand side. So by placing multiple VSA sync elements, we can look at the additional distortion being introduced to the waveform at various stages of the design. In this case, we can evaluate the incremental distortion being added by the power amplifier. Likewise, if we replace the VSA sync element behind the HDL co-simulation element, we would be able to evaluate the fixed point impairments being introduced to the waveform. Let's perform our simulation. And these are our simulation results at the output of the preamplifier. We can see that the preamplifier 1 dB compression point is introducing some distortion to the constellation. This also reflects the fixed point nature of the HDL code that's being co-simulated. Spectrum is shown on the lower left. EVM is at around 3.5%, again reflecting both the HDL fixed point impairments as well as the preamplifier impairments. These are the power amplifier, or PA, simulation results, and we can see that the PA is introducing significant distortion to the waveform. Constellation is quite impaired. We see spectral regrowth on the spectrum, and EVM has degraded to 11.1%. So in this video, we've shown HDL co-simulation with RF design. This capability can be quite useful for software-defined radio physical layer waveform design and verification, and can help the system engineer to evaluate baseband versus RF performance requirements and help to bring the two designs together to help minimize or mitigate system integration risks. Thank you for your time today.